Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Koalipops. Today we are making Marvel's newest superhero. That's right, Captain Planet. Captain Planet, he's a hero, gonna save you from tobacco. I don't know the rest of the words. I think I was on the right track though, so we're gonna leave it there. I love this dress. It looks so regal. She looks like she's going to a ballroom, and those gloves makes it look like she's going to a ballroom full of villains. This doll cake is a little too late for Captain Marvel the movie, but it's just in time for Avengers Endgame. Or it's also 3 months after Endgame has premiered. It all depends on when you're watching this video. I love this cake, so let's get started. Now make sure you hit that notification button so you can see all of my videos as they come out. I used to only produce videos like once a week, but now it's like 3 times a week, so there's a lot of stuff for you guys. Let's create this doll cake. I am using my Walton's doll cake pan. I love this pan, you guys. I've made so many beautiful designs with it. I started getting into doll cakes again. I took a very long hiatus from them and then I started again. So I made Tiana, and then I made Jasmine, and Rapunzel, Sleeping Beauty, and Tinkerbell. And 4 of those videos are not yet released, so they're coming. The Jasmine cake took a lot of work, but it was worth it. It comes out next month when the movie's released. So I have to sit down, I have to sketch each dress, and my favorite part is taking all of those elements that I sketched and turning them into fun pieces. You know, you place them onto the dress, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't, and then those videos don't get published. Now to create Captain Marvel's dress, I am covering the entire cake with like a beacon blue. Actually, you know, it's more of a cosmic cobalt. Which is great because I like that color better. Beacon blue is too deep. Way too deep. And I'm kind of a shallow person, but you know, that's a different story. So I covered the entire cake with a cobalt blue. I added a little bit of detail to the fondant before I placed it on. Was that a mistake? Kind of. Because the lines I created don't really flow with the folds at the bottom, and I think they should because it doesn't look as realistic. Mistake! I tried to interpret Captain Marvel's suit. This looks like a flight suit from the US Navy. Oh god. This looks like a flight suit from the Air Force. A cosmic flight suit from the cosmic Air Force. There's a lot of padding and detail on her suit, and I kind of did away with all that just because I wanted this dress to be simple and elegant. Now my favorite thing about Captain Marvel is her energy blast. I love the way that she articulates the blast. Like, she makes a fist, a bow, like that. But so much cooler. There was one scene that really bothered me. I just hated it. Captain Marvel goes to a bar with Nick Fury, and Nick Fury asks her, "What is your power?" And Captain Marvel points her fist at a jukebox, and she blows the jukebox to bits. Did she own that jukebox? No. Did she own that bar? No. Guess who doesn't have respect for anybody else's things? Why did she have to do that? Do you know how expensive it is to replace classic, vintage, retro jukeboxes? I don't know either, but it seems like it'd be very expensive. The owner of the bar was there too. You owe him money. Before you go out into the universe saving everybody, can you pay that guy back? Because he's gonna have to spend a lot of money to repair that jukebox. You know how many records you ruined. What if there was a Dolly Parton record in that jukebox, and it was limited edition, and she signed it, and now it's gone because you pointed your fist at it and you blew it away? You can't do that to stuff that's not yours. You need to have respect. That's all I'm saying. Okay, Captain Marvel, that's all I'm saying. One aspect I did incorporate into this is the top of Captain Marvel's suit. So the bottom of her top, like the torso area, is blue, and then the rest of it is all red. And I went for a sleeveless look just because she's really covered up with her suit. Oh, I was not expecting that. And now we know that the hands come off. But I gave it a high neckline, just like that. In the comic book, Captain Marvel's outfit has a sash, and I wanted to incorporate that on this dress, so I made a giant sash. Starts at the left side of her hip and just wraps all the way down to the right. Now, another aspect that I liked about the movie was Goose, just because before I used to be a dog person, but then I got a cat and I really started to appreciate their sort of mannerisms. I know this has nothing to do with the movie, but go watch How to Train Your Dragon 3. That is 3. Yeah, that's 3. I was scared that I put 4. I've done that so many times. How to Train Your Dragon 3, the one of the things I really liked was Toothless acts like a dog, and the Light Fury acts like a really cute cat. You can see the differences in the way that the animals move. It's just so cool. Now let's get back to the cake. I wanted to change this up a little bit and take the star in the middle of her chest and kind of use it all over the cake. So I created several stars, and the largest of the stars is actually right where the end of the sash is. I thought it would look like a shooting star. That was the idea. I created 4 other stars to wrap around the entire dress. And finally, I wrapped a much smaller star at her waist. Now, Captain Marvel has this bomb leather jacket. Doesn't look that nice on the doll, but in real life, it looks pretty cool. I didn't want to give her a jacket because I wanted you to be able to see that it was a sleeveless dress. And because she's a superhero, I decided to give her a cape, a gold cape. I just wrapped some gold fondant around the back and added 2 small pieces of fondant to give her like shoulder pads. Then it was time to paint, because guess what? I am who I am, and that's a person that loves luster dust. Because there is so much detail on this, I decided to add some blue luster dust and just highlight different parts of the gown. Now with gold luster dust, I painted the sash as well as each of the stars and the cape. Painting this cape gold, painting any cape gold is really cool. I love gold luster dust. I use it all the time. I think I overuse it most of the time because I just apply it to everything, especially doll cakes, but I like it and I'm not going to apologize. Yes, I am, because sometimes I don't need it. But voila, see, after I painted it, my Captain Marvel cake was done. Now in hindsight, I probably wouldn't have painted the blue onto the dress. It kind of takes away from the shininess of the gold. But it still looks pretty bomb, so I'm not gonna complain too much. It is Wednesday, my dudes. And the only thing I can really think about is how I get to watch Avengers Endgame tomorrow. Now I'm curious, I have made a lot of doll cakes on this channel. Who should I make next? I have a ton of ideas, but I want your input, so let me know in the comments below. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I love you. I will see you very soon. Peace!